Hey guys, MrMav96 here, back with some more Braid. As always, my controller decides that, oh, it actually works for once. So, today, we're going to be starting World 5, I believe, in this episode. So, something interesting about this is that you sort of have a second you in this world. So, while you might not get everything and do everything, you might have your second you get your stuff. So you've got sort of a shadow clone of sorts. Anything that glows purple, I believe, does not gain a shadow clone. But the shadow clone only lasts for the actions that you do. So let's say I do this, right? Shadow clone. Hang on, I'm trying to remember how shadow clones work this game. Oh yeah, it does the action that you did right before, so it's kind of interesting actually. And I'm not sure which one I like, this one or the last one more. So we do this, and so purple things don't get a shadow clone, right? So, anything purple does not really get a shadow clone of itself. So, if I go back and I do this, I can count on my shadow clone going over and flipping the switch, I believe. Go on. It's a switch. You can... Okay, I guess I can't count on my shadow clone, you know, flip a simple switch. So if I count on my shadow clone, so I want to do this, and then I want to give myself enough time afterward that I can do whatever I need to be done. So I'm going to go back to here, and now my shadow clone is going to go up there, and he's going to flick that switch for me. It kind of breaks the brain to have the shadow clone, and I don't know what else to call it, so I'm just going to call it my shadow clone, because that sounds cool. Alright, this level does not appear to have an actual name. But purple things do not get reversed from your shadow clone. So if I were to actually kill this guy, he'd die completely. So my shadow clone is going to go down there and he's going to get that. Now, the problem with this is that I need this right here. So if I go back and I go right here, he's going to go over and he's going to take that key down here. I'm pretty sure I messed that up, so let's see, what can I do with this? Well, for one, I can go over here, and there's the door, but I don't have everything. So if I do this, then my shadow clone is going to go down there, and it's going to distract that guy for me. Right? He's going to go over there, and then he's going to kill... I did not do that right. I did not do that right in the slightest, so... Let's try this again. This time with gusto. So we go down here and we distract this guy, right? We keep this guy distracted. And then what we do is we go back in time so that our shadow clone distracts this guy instead of us. He's gonna go down there. He's gonna take the attention off of Mr. Bunny Rabbit slash Nidoran, as I lovingly call it. Just long enough for us to do this. So if we do this, then our shadow clone is going to get the key, and he's going to do stuffs, I think. That's not exactly the stuffs that I wanted to be done. So if I do this, and then I try to jump at the same time. Alright, come on. Wait, I had it. I got it! Somehow. That was weird. I'm probably gonna get cut out. A lot of that. But we got it. We got the puzzle piece after... I don't even know what just happened there. See, that's what happens sometimes in this game. And that's one thing that I kind of don't like about this game. Is that you get into situations where you don't really know what the crap just happened. So if you go down there, you kill this guy, then I take this guy over. Oh, right, because I'm a stupid. Yeah, this will count as a bridge. And now, I just need to bounce up off this guy. Now the second part is going to be much similar. It's going to be done much the same way, I think. Again, it's been a while since I've done this. Wait, no. I just gotta do that. Okay, so what's the final puzzle piece? I forget. Oh, right. This. Okay, so this is gonna be something a bit weird. I'm not sure how well this is gonna work. So I need to have my clone go down there and do that. And so now, I need to go right here so that he... I need to get him to jump on me, basically. I get it now. Okay. I've just been being stupid this whole time. So, I'm not sure how much of that's gonna be cut out, but hopefully quite a bit. So what I need to do, for those of you who don't get it yet, so, I was on the right track with what I had to do. I've got it. There we go. I'm smart. I swear I've played this before. I swear. Alright, so. What's going on here? I remember these levels, I just don't remember necessarily how to solve them. So this is gonna get progressively harder. Alright, so that got opened. That got done opened. So, that will not reopen because it was purpley. So now what we can do is we can do this. I don't know what that was actually supposed to do. I think I was actually supposed to keep that open. Until, yes! That's what I was supposed to do. And now, that's erased. I can come back here and grab this piece. So that's the first piece of this room. Pretty simple, pretty simple. All right, and now the next piece is what? Ah, so like this. I need to come back down here. Hang on. So I need to come over here. This guy is gonna flip the switch for me. Oh my gosh, you gotta be kidding me. So what I actually have to do... Okay, that makes sense. So that guy's gonna go, that me is gonna go and he's gonna flip the switch, right? So then this me is gonna go and he's gonna flip the switch. So now this me over here is gonna be going up here and onto this. Well, that me is down there and being raised and flipping the switch, right? Right? That's how this works? No. Okay, so I guess what I have to do is that guy has to go down there and flip the switch. Oh my gosh, you've got to be kidding me. So I guess what I've got to do is I've got to come up here, flip the switch, rewind time, go down here, go here, wait until it's all the way up here, flip the switch, wait a while, then rewind time back to now, and flip this so this guy is up here. So when he flips the switch, oh, but then I need to be over here. Oh, I'm so stupid. I didn't realize I was supposed to be over here. Okay, I've got it now. So I need to go over here, flip the switch. Then I'll be back down here. I need to go over here. Wait a few seconds, then... Oh, you stupid. I need to wait a few seconds after I flip the switch. Alright, so I need to wait a few seconds after I flip the switch. Da-da-da. I need to rewind to before I hit the switch. Now I've got to wait a few seconds before I hit the switch, and now I'll hit the switch. And now I'll rewind to before I hit that switch. I'm going to hit this switch and then jump on here. And now that means it's going to hit the switch. Yeah. Ballin'. Now I'm going to get this. I don't remember how many levels there are to this world. But there's a lair. So we're probably getting pretty close. I'm pretty sure we weren't supposed to be able to do that. Alright, so this guy, he does not follow the rules of shadow cloning. Alright, good. Oh, but wait, I need to hit him with the shadow clone one. There we go. Alright, that's what I have to do. So, can I hit him with the shadow clone one? So if I hit him with the real one and then I rewind time before I nailed it, then yeah! So I've just basically got to hit him and then rewind. that's all this is, pretty much. It's just hitting him and then rewinding to before I hit him. That's all I have to do to get a hit off on him, apparently. And I'm apparently doing terribly. Get over here, get under the things. Then rewind before I hit him. And boom. See, I'm trying to relearn this because I know a lot of the early game, I just don't know a lot of the later game. Get over here, buddy. You know you want to. Then rewind. Have this guy hit him. Then hit him down here. Grab the key. And instead of actually going forward, I'm going to go over here. And grab the switch. And this me is going to go over and he's going to hit the switch. Apparently. I guess I'm just being stupid now. But I know what I have to do. You come over here, use this, hit the switch, and then I need to give myself enough time to go back, go here, and then get over here. So that other me should be going over and getting this to open. And so I can go through and Fragile Companion. I forget how many levels there are. I honestly do. So if I do this, and I open this, and then I rewind time. Oh wait, but that's a shiny key. Okay, so that would stay. This is the end of the world. So let's see. Okay, so what I need to do is I need to kill this guy, grab the key, then immediately... Oh, frick. I'm stupid. Hang on. So my shadow me can open these doors, but because this is a... Oh, wait. If I do this, then that shadow me is gonna... Yeah! Okay, that's it. He just has to have momentum. Alright, sorry that took me so long and I had to cut, but... That is the end of this world. So. Hi, I'm lost. How are you? So, now that we have all of these, we can start doing the puzzle. At least I think we have all of these. I hope we have all of these. Maybe we don't. It doesn't look like we have very many. Also, these puzzles are getting significantly harder to solve. I wish that you could, like, set aside pieces a lot easier. Also, I'm using a controller, but I kind of feel like it would be more natural for me to use the mouse on this part. Just because of the nature of what this is. Alright, so... Put that there, put this here. And... Alright, that there, that there. This obviously now goes here. This obviously goes here. No, it goes here, obviously. Man, anybody thinking that it didn't, it would be stupid. AKA me. Alright, put the puzzle together, and boom! That is puzzle number 4 complete. next time we will be tackling World 6. I will see you all next time. Bye.